So how did I become a freelance data analyst without having a related degree like computer science, statistics, or econometry? In today's video, I'm gonna share my story and give you some advice if you wanna follow the same path. What's up, guys? My name's Stefan, and if you're new here, I'm a freelance data analyst currently working in Amsterdam, Holland. Funny enough, I'll be quitting my job later this year, but more on that later. First, let's get straight into it. A little backstory about my life before becoming a data analyst. I never knew I wanted to become a data analyst. And while studying, the possibility of me becoming a data analyst hasn't even occurred to me once. After I finished high school, I chose to study something called industrial engineering and management. It's basically a combination between engineering and business administration. And apart from some subjects like calculus, linear algebra, and statistics, it had absolutely nothing to do with data science. When I finished university and got my degree, I still had no idea what to do with my career and my life. So what do most people do when they have absolutely no idea what they want to do with their life? That's right. They go backpacking in Southeast Asia to find themselves deep inside the Asian jungles. I went backpacking in Southeast Asia as a form of escapism. I was escaping the fact that I still had no idea what I wanted to do with my career. So when I came back after 3 months, now really broke, I was faced with the harsh reality that I had to get a job as soon as possible. So I got my first job that kind of matched what I was studying, and I became a recruiter in the tech sector. On the first day of that job, I knew this wasn't for me. So after exactly 1 month, I quit my job. And that's when I started this IT management traineeship in Amsterdam, which was basically the start of my career as a data analyst. So how do you become a data analyst? To become a data analyst, there are a few key skills you need to learn before picking up any online courses or technical tools. And the first skill you must acquire is having an analytical mindset. Being analytical means to apply logical reasoning to find out more about something. It means you have to be willing to ask questions, the right questions, to break down problems and issues to the very essence so that they might lead to further insights. For me personally, this began when I started my IT management traineeship as a performance analyst, and I got to use Microsoft Excel on a more advanced level. I started building reports and dashboards in Excel. I started using VLOOKUPs, pivot tables, and even building some macros with VBA. I had no prior professional experience with Excel, but got the hang of it pretty fast with the help of my colleagues and of course the internet. You can learn basically any programming language or tools for free on the internet. More on that later. I thank most of my analytical skills to that first job where I got to use Excel. And the second skill, and probably the most important one, is you need to keep on learning and developing your data analysis skill set. This is because the data science field is such a dynamic environment, and new data is being generated at an exponentially growing rate, meaning new tools, new software, new programming languages are developed almost every other day to keep up with the fast-paced world of data analysis. Which brings me to the tools you need to get started. There are a ton of different tools to analyze data, ranging from simple and low volume data to complex and high volume data. For low volume data, we use tools like Excel, VBA, SQL, Python, and R. And for high volume and complex data, we use more tools like Hadoop, Splunk, and again, Python and R. Now I know this might sound intimidating. Just make sure you pick one tool or one programming language and stick with it. Try to master it. I would recommend starting with Microsoft Excel as well. Excel is a very easy to use an intuitive tool that a lot of corporations and organizations use daily. It's a very basic and all-around data analysis tool with a very visually focused user interface, which can take away the abstract aspect of data analysis. In simpler terms, you see what you build. When I pretty much learned everything there is to learn in Microsoft Excel, I started using Power BI, which is a business intelligence tool. Because nowadays I see more and more data analysts acquiring business intelligence skills and tools because data visualization is a very important aspect of data analysis. And Power BI is exactly that, a way to extract, transform, and load your data for you to visualize it in interactive graphs, tables, or other visuals. I can tell you, managers love these kind of dashboards. Other popular BI tools are Tableau, ClickSense, and MicroStrategy. I would recommend deep diving into a BI tool of your choice as soon as you feel comfortable with all the advanced functions in Excel. I personally chose Microsoft Power BI because it fits so well with Microsoft Excel, because of course it's the Microsoft stack, but you could go for any of the other mentioned BI tools as well. Once I got the hang of Power BI, I started developing my Python skills. jobs. And I was lucky enough that my manager at that time offered the opportunity to me and my team to take a Python course, an 8-week Python course, to start developing our Python skills. This really helped us understanding the foundation and the basics of Python, and we actually pretty quickly started using it in our day-to-day jobs. It's a programming language that you can use for data analysis, but you can use it for so much more. So if you have the opportunity to learn Python, whether it's through your job or at home in the evening, do it. Convince your manager of the value of knowing Python and see if he can actually pay any of your courses or certifications for you. And otherwise, pay it yourself, because it's worth it. And I'll drop a couple of resources in the description to some online courses. Some are free and some require a payment, but see it as an investment in yourself. It will pay out, trust me, because it did for me. As soon as I developed my Excel, Power BI and Python skills, and I had a couple of years of working experience as a data analyst, things went really fast. I got hired for a big multinational where I got to develop my BI skills in a very dynamic and complex environment. And I also started doing some freelance data analysis projects on the side. After working there for almost 2 years, I quit my job and went full-time into freelancing. And I work full-time as a freelance data analyst, a freelance contractor. A data analyst contractor. I've now been working as a freelancer for almost 2 years at one of the biggest banks in Holland. So my point is that data analysis, data science, business intelligence is a booming market right now. And the demand for quality data analysts will only keep growing in the foreseeable future. But to become a quality data analyst, you need to land that first job. So how do you land your first job as a data analyst? So the way I got into data analysis is by applying to an IT traineeship. Traineeships are really becoming more popular, as they're a good way to grow your technical skills really fast. Traineeships also serve as a perfect transition from school to work, or from one career to the other. Now, another way that worked great for me is to use LinkedIn. If you pimp up your LinkedIn profile correctly, this will be a great way for recruiters to find you. Make sure you add all the certifications, courses, and work experience related to data analysis. In the header, use keywords like data analyst, data scientist, or business intelligence specialist, basically anything related to data analysis. If you combine this with a very short description of you and your backstory, and you can drop in a couple of those keywords in there as well, recruiters will start hunting you very soon. That's what happened to me. Apart from that first job, all the other jobs I landed were because recruiters approached me through LinkedIn. Use this to your advantage. And of course, once you've entered the data analysis world, your network will expand as well, and it will become easier to land future jobs and projects. So in conclusion, if you want to start this journey, know that a career as a data analyst is both an interesting one and a rewarding one. You will get to challenge and grow your analytical skills while also having an outlet for your creativity, as building dashboards and reports sometimes really does feel like you have a blank canvas in front of you for you to paint on. Which brings me to the fact why I'm quitting my job. Not only am I quitting my current job, but the plan is to leave my data analysis career completely. Not because I don't like it, but because I found something that I like more, namely expressing my creativity through videos, my YouTube channel basically. And I will be sharing my journey of quitting my job, leaving behind the whole corporate office life, and start traveling the world next year, where I can fully focus on my new way of expressing my creativity and my urge for entrepreneurship. If you want to follow me on the journey or learn more about personal development or personal finance, then definitely subscribe. I also have an Instagram where you can follow my journey through my photos and stories. I hope you find this video valuable, and I wish you all the luck on your journey of becoming a data analyst. See you in the next video. Cheers! Which brings me to the fact to break down problems and issues to the very essence in order to find something. Transform and load your data. So the way I got into data analysis is by applying to an IT traineeship.